Yeah, it's coming.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice. So,
check the other two.
So the same system with a different parameter, with a different parameter values, can.
It's interesting. Which value? Okay.
For a high value of R, the Lorentz system gives you the periodic orbit. You can also try. For a high value of R, if you consider this rho as 99 point something, 99.123, you can see the periodic orbit. Simple. You don't need to write down the Runge Kutta code. So it's already inbuilt in MATLAB.
So you just syntax it is, it's ODE45. You just write down the function, its domain, and the initial values. Then you can get the result directly.
Okay. Can you get this same figure for these parameter values?
These are called the saddle points. So if you can get this, can you check the time series? The one variable versus time, can you check? In the chaotic case as well as in this case, how is the time series?
So now you can change it.
Yeah.
This is a very influential parameter. This one is a very influential parameter. If you put R is equal to 25 plus, you see the chaotic attractor. Here you can see it like this. If you can go further, if you put R is equal to 99 point something, you can see the periodic attractor. Check that. Okay, so this is the plot, the three dimensional plot. You do the 2D plot, plot T versus any of the variable. Plot T, comma either x1 or x2 or x3. You can see the time series. Draw the time series. You need to know the proposal. You have the proposal? So if you can have a bifurcation diagram between 99 point, which was the previous one? 99. Okay, so if you go 99.67, something like that, you can see that it's more tending to the periodic orbit. That's very interesting. Okay, for the time series, you just change the program a little bit.
not, it should not be three dimensional. It's a plot. You have to write the time as a cost variable, comma, if you want the time variation for with respect to x, which will be your syntax. And okay, so you could be 28 as our original value. This is the time series. Let me know if you can get a periodic orbit for the body. That means, okay, you put r is equal to 13, and see the time series. You put r is equal to 13, and you see the time series. It looks like this. This is the time series. Time series means t versus variable. You put r is equal to 13, you must get this kind of things. Check. Why? The question is why? Is this zero? This one is zero. Are you? Take the phase space, not the time series, for 99.96. For rho is equal to 99.96. Rho means R. 99.96 should give you a multiplicative value. Any question on the knowledge? So you know how to solve the three-dimensional ODE. Any question? Means that for time t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 100. If you want to go more on time, so you can put 0 to 200, 300, 400 up to you. If you want to delete the initial data, so you can start from time 50 to 100, something like that. Okay, 15, 20, 30 are the initials. You can change according to your own.
This one is another dynamical model, it is called the Rossler system. It is also a three-dimensional system. So I remind you that
it's dx dt, dy dt, dz dt. So the system is like
dx dt, dy dt and dz dt, x, y, z are the variables and the right side is minus y minus z for the first equation, x plus a y for the second equation, b plus z into x minus c for the third equation. So x, y, z are the variables, a, b, c are the parameters, same like Lorentz. Here for the chaotic scenario, a is equals to 0.2, b is equals to 0.2, c is equals to 5.7. So before you simulate, just let me know what are the fixed points of the system and then you solve it by using ODE45, same what you did by for the Lorentz. So here just the equations are different, it's another system. Dx dt, sorry for the mixture, this is y and this is z. So right hand side is okay.
So number one, show me the fixed point of the system, and number two, show me the attractor of the Rossler. For this parameter values. For the fixed point, don't put the numerical values. Calculate the fixed point for A, B, C,
and then you do the simulation. So A, B, C are the system parameters, those are the constant. X, Y, Z are the variables which will give the solution.
No, you can do the same code for the Lorentz, you just adjust for the Rossler.
But also check the other program. So before you simulate, you just do the fixed point. Let me know what are the fixed point for the Rossler.
Random because it's just to show you how it works, but we have to go in a systematic way. So tell me what is the fixed point, x0, y0 and z0.
You can use the same code for Lorentz to solve it numerically. For the simulation, it can work for any three-dimensional system. looks like that.
Fixed points are
check, check.
If you don't understand or if you have any confusion, tell me. Feel free to ask me.
The Rossmann equation.
Is the Rossmann?
I mean the equations.
This is the equation. Just sit here.
You're changing it across now.
This is the first equation.
This is the second equation. Follow the semicolon.
This one is the first.
This one is the second. This one is the third.
For Lorentz.
So you have to change it for the last.
You change and then you put the parameter for the.
The initial x is 0.
It's fine.
No. Can should we assume the x dt to 0? Can we assume this one is equal to 0?
Yes, 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 obviously.
And this one equal to 0.
Exactly. Then so minus y minus z equals to 0, x plus ay is equals to 0, v plus z into x minus c is equals to 0. Three algebraic equation. Okay, just solve it. Minus y is the same. X plus a y is the same. So v plus z into x minus. Just concentrate and try to solve. Solve it analytically. No, so y is equal to minus a, perfect. So you put this value to the other two equations.
ABC.
Try. Lorentz and Rossler are considered the simplest examples of dynamic system. But simple but effective. Change the equations?
Yeah.
Okay. See whether this is correct. X1 minus z into x minus c is a whole bracket. Okay. So change the initials. Take the very small initial. It should come. Let me know if you can find out the output. Check the 6-5 first.
What is x, what is y, what is z, right?
Zahari, there is another one, the rho d dot mu, you try that one. For the simulation. The other one, the ODE.NU, it is more generalized. So you check the other one, ODE.NU, there is a folder. You go to the folder. So it was also designed for Lorentz. You change the variable in the there are two files. One is Lorentz and another one is solution. So you go to the Lorentz file and change the equations and then run the solution. You go to the ODE.NU folder, you see there are two files, one is Lorentz and another one is solution. You change the Lorentz, you run it fast, you run the solution fast and check whether the Lorentz extractor is coming or not. If it is coming, then change the system to the Rossler and run the solution again. You see the Rossler will come. And your homework is find the difficulties in the previous one.
So when I get this one, x, y, and z,
perfect.
Then the initial, no, this is only this.
Yeah, these are the values.
They are not. This is this.
Exactly. X0, y0, z0. You see there? You see there? There are two fixed points, right? Save the program ODE.NU, you can do it for any ODE system, whatever the dimension is. That increase the, if it is four dimensional, that increase the function health, it will work. Try for Rossler, and it will work for any ODE. You design the functions in the program number one, and then run the solution. Not working. Go to the. Okay, you don't use that one. You need the other one. You copy the photos. There is a lot. Okay. You run the solution. Program. It's an equation of motion of a damped oscillator. You check the equations d2 theta dt2, what we discussed in our previous lecture. The damped oscillators are chaotic. So here is the example with the MATLAB code. I think it's a complete code. If you run, you can get a
I don't know, the phase space and the Poincare restriction. Either phase space of the Poincare restriction or the time series of the Poincare restriction. Check the program. Working or not, the program.
Can you check the phase space of the system, the damped oscillator?
I think the later one is a Poincare restriction with the intersection of the plane. But can you check the phase space and the time series?
Yeah, can you go for the whole phase space? This is, I think, a section. practice this things.
If anything, any difficulties come, you feel free to ask me anytime.
You can also check, I have a web page. If you type my name in Google. So this is the Google site where you can see my books and publications and everything. So if you find anything interesting, you just let me know. The Lyapunov, the Lyapunov exponent. As I mentioned, Lyapunov exponent is a very useful tool. I gave you a ready program of the Lyapunov exponent for the Lorentz. You go and just run the program. It's a complete program for the Lyapunov. And you take a printout later and you understand what is inside in the program. You need to know a few things for the Lyapunov. So later.
Write down this article. This is Physica D, Elsevier Journal, in 1985. You have to read this article to know how the Lyapunov exponent can be constructed for simulation. I already gave you the ready program, but just don't run it blindly. You need to know what is inside the program. So for this article is very, very useful. You just note down the reference, you can download it, and here you just open the program for the Lyapunov and check whether it is working or not. You can see the full spectrum of Lyapunov for Lorentz, the three Lyapunov, and one should be positive, one is zero, one is negative. Check if the program is working, and then later you understand what is inside the program.
There should be a bracket, obviously.
What's this? Is it the generation of the Lyapunov?
What is that?
I want to talk about the Lyapunov parts. This is the
you see the what is there? Something is mentioned to be printed.
One year.
only of your future project. There is also one program, even the time series and FFTC, there is a program called time series. You can check it later. It's a full program of data and its corresponding time series, how the FFT works and everything. It's a completely ready program. So these are the basic programs actually to know about the dynamics of system. The most important is how to solve it numerically. The numerical codes are very, very important. You can check it. The Lorentz and Rosler are too important. There are plenty of other dynamical systems. If you go to Google and you can search for the chaotic dynamical systems in 3-dimensional, 4-dimensional, 5-dimensional, 6-dimensional, you can have many, many systems. You can modify it according to the system and you can run, you can get the chaotic abstractor. For the Lyapunov code, we can have it from the system as well as we can have it from the signals. For the time series, we can have it from the time series as given here, also we can have it from the system. Lorentz 1 and the ODNU for the ODE system. Pendulum is a 2-dimensional periodic pendulum. Time series is for the time series and its FFT. Now we can see what is inside the image. So this is an image encryption based on the chaotic masking. So we can proceed to the image folder.
See, there are two files. So no, the three files. One is the image, and there are massive codes. So it is an image encryption based on the Lorentz system. So that's why the Lorentz is also given in as a code, and the other one is the image encryption program. So if you can open the Lorentz, it's the same Lorentz what we did before. You can change your function according to your system, and you run the other program. It is actually downloaded from internet, so you just check whether it is working or not. We use the Lorentz variable basically. what I can see here, and we take the take the keys
from the Lorentz variable, and we use the reshape code. You see, there is a this A7, B7 or other reshape. So basically, it's just a shuffling using the Lorentz system. Check if it is working. Something also in this program on the sensitive dependence on the initial condition. That's why the error comes. So you see, if the two values are exactly the same, then you can have the error 0 and you can have the complete image. And if it is a slightly different what it is given in the program, then you can have a erroneous result. You can also have a look at the corresponding error. Okay, so what is new actually in the area of chaos theory? Okay, there is a message from Firdaus. Dr. Santo, if my staff not bring the certificate, then you can tell to the participant that they can take the certificate general office next week. So you are not getting the certificate today, but you should get it by next week. Okay. So the concluding part is that what is new in the, if you are interested in the field of research in chaos theory, then what you can do. So the thing is that every day there are research, to work on the chaos theory there are two kinds of research. Either you create your own dynamical system, because it's a system based research. We have to construct a dynamical system, or we have to work on the dynamical system. So there are two types of research. Either you create your own dynamical systems and do the usual analysis on that system. You have a new system and you can do the FFT, the Lyapunov, the bifurcation, the Poincaré section, etc., etc. on that system. That is one kind of research. The other kind of research is you take any dynamical systems available in the article and you do some new analysis on that. Don't do the Lyapunov, the Poincaré and etc. Do some new study, new kind of study. So there are plenty of nonlinear studies also associated with the dynamical system. So the most interesting is that that if you can have your own dynamical system. So long before, in the year 2001, I have a dynamical system. If you can go to my site, you can see in 2001.
I can show you here. This article, Theoretic Aspects of Lasers with Host-Induced Nonlinearity and its Control. You can write down the reference. It's Physics Letters A, volume, page, and etc. So if you go through the article, you will see that there is a dynamical system, which is a five-dimensional dynamical system. It's completely new. So in this article, in the Physics Letters A, we
we just constructed the dynamical system from a state of partial differential equation from the Maxwell's original system. So after that, we did not have any further research on that. Maybe Aliu did some research on that, but it's still there are many things to do. So that is a new kind of dynamical system that you can have, and you can study the whole things, the Poincaré, the FFT, the Lyapunov, the bifurcation, etc. for this kind of system. And also, if you can find out recently, in the 2014, 2015, there are many articles on the various dynamical systems. If you have your own system, or if you can have relatively new dynamical systems, then it is easy. It do something numerically and also by simulation to publish. So basically, the research on chaos is that you have to show the system is chaotic, you have to show the chaotic properties, and you have to show at least one application. How the chaos is applicable in either communication, in control, or in any field of research. You can use the time series to do, if you are working on the data analysis, you can do your data analysis, the recurrence plot, etc. You can use the system for the prediction, you can use the time series for the synchronization, you can use the time series for the network, and many other kind of things. You can use the chaos, you can use the complexity. I suggest if you just read some basic articles, if you need any help from me to read a few basic articles, if you are interested. So you feel free to write me, feel free to come to my office anytime, and then you can proceed doing research with the chaos. The most important and interesting fact is that it's still very, very easy to publish. It's not so difficult to publish. As far as the publication is concerned, if you have something new, something novel, then it's get accepted easily. So, yeah, so that's all. So let me know, what is your impression on chaos theory? Yeah, tell me. Yeah. So, what do you think? Is it, yeah. Yeah, that's for sure. But I'm talking about what do you think about the research on this field? Is it interesting? Is it very difficult, or is it very easy?
Interesting
and challenging. Okay. Any other comment? Aliu, what do you think about chaos theory? Because you have some experience.
Yeah, very interesting
indeed. Interesting in the sense that you can visualize everything. What you are doing, you can see. So, but you have to be careful about, because the analytically we cannot proceed much. We have to go for either simulation or the numerical things. So, that's the main issue here. But the researchers are going to be more and more complex every day. So just not only the ordinary systems. Now it's time to different kind of systems. For example, time delay. For example, the direct spatiotemporal systems. But still, there are many things to do. Okay, if you want to ask me anything, then you can ask. And so that's all for today.